Hey guys, today we're in Chiba Prefecture in an area called Narita-san Omotesando, but it's not the one in Tokyo.
No.
And we've been invited for something really exciting. If you've only got one day left in Japan, you have to come check out Narita-san area because it's right near the airport and you can find Japanese street food, you can find traditional Japanese town vibes, and it's still a hidden gem.
Yeah, it's actually, in 2024, it's the 70th anniversary of Narita becoming a city. So we wanted to show you today what there is to check out.
Let's go explore!
Let's go! Okay, we're already at our first spot, which is Hayashida no osenbei. So osenbei,
rice crackers.
And I've never seen them so freshly cooked before.
I know, they're gonna be really hot and warm and crispy. This is one of my favorite street foods because a lot of street food is sweet, but this is savory, baby.
For the savory girl. I'm the sweet girl.
They have a sweet one too, though, so let's get one. Like, they're ready.
Ooh, they're dipping them fresh. Konnichiwa. It's hot. It's like hot. I've never had a hot, fresh senbei before. Usually you just get them in a packet and they're already cooled down and everything.
It smells so delightful as well, like that hot cooked soy sauce. Let's get into it.
Cheers.
Thunk. Yo.
All senbei should be hot.
This slaps
hard. That's delicious. Crunchy, crispy. That salty shoyu flavor.
I love that when I bite into it, it doesn't hurt like my mouth either, because some senbei are like killing my gut.
I thought your head turned into a senbei. Oh my gosh, it looks like a prop for a movie.
Wow.
That's massive.
And this is a great souvenir.
You take it.
Giant summer.
Giant summer.
Oh, good.
Shall we see what else we can find on the shopping street? Try more foods?
Let's go. We're at Kintoki no Amatoro to eat some traditional Japanese snacks.
Woohoo.
What are they called again?
Amatoro.
In the name.
But also, they actually come with lots of different names. I've had this before, as it's called Imagawa Yaki, or it's also called Obanyaki. There's heaps of different names. So
it's essentially like red bean paste inside, and I've got a red one.
Well, red bean paste or white bean paste. So I got the white bean because white bean is superior. Come fight me. Super fresh and super warm.
Yeah, you can see them baking it right behind us. So when it was handed to us, it was like hot, like hot potato.
It was very hot.
But I have literally like beans inside here and I like it when they're not like mushed entirely.
Oh, you like a little bit of texture. Is it tsubu an?
Yeah, it's tsubu an.
Tsubu an. Yeah, so usually I think people mostly know taiyaki when it comes to something cooked this way. Whereas taiyaki, I feel like it's got maybe a softer exterior. Whereas this has a nice crispy shell and then a very fluffy, dough.
These are only about 150 yen each, so it's very cheap street food, which is what we've come here to find.
So apparently this shop is about 70 years old, same age that Narita is as a city. 70 years ago, became a city.
Our combined ages aren't even 70.
You're right.
You can also pick up lots of souvenirs on this street and they've got things like peanuts.
Chiba's famous for peanuts. So if you're a peanut lover, this is the place to get them. But especially because it's close to the airport, if you're on your way there or about to fly out, you can get all your
last
souvenirs
minute
here.
Stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah, and there's also traditional souvenirs like mugs, you know, clothing, fans, all that fun stuff.
Yeah, lots of different shops. We have come off of the main street a little bit and we've come to this cute little cafe called Hashira Deli and Cafe, and they are known for their latte art, but it's not just lattes. I got a hojicha latte. Well, I guess that's still a latte.
And a matcha latte.
Okay, maybe they are just lattes. But I got a roasted green tea, and you got a calfee.
So a coffee. Yeah, and they all got different little characters. We had a cat on the matcha, we had a girl wearing a cat hat, and you have a bunny.
I got a bunny.
So cute.
Yeah, so cute. I'm very excited to just tuck in.
And it's great because we can relax here. It's like a tatami room, and then there's also very traditional Japanese like architecture in here. And it's just kind of tucked away.
Just, nice like local
cozy
vibe.
Cozy, yeah. And it's right near the station, only a 1 minute walk.
True. So we cheers?
I'm sad to like get rid of the design.
Yum.
Delicious.
Oh, that's so good. That's what the ho in hojicha is. When you drink it, you go ho.
Well, the latte here is really smooth. Like, I can tell they're really good at making coffee. So if you want a hot coffee, on your day here in Narita, you gotta get that. And I'm gonna give the matcha a try.
Yeah, go for it. The hojicha is so good. It's just a nice amount of flavor, really creamy with the milk, and just, I love frothy milk.
Like, yeah? This one's frothy too, and I like the balance between like the sweetness and the bitterness of this matcha. It's like the perfect amount. This is the kind of place I would come to. I love this kind of atmosphere.
It's really cute.
Just chilling out.
I just want to chill out for a little bit. I feel like this is giving me energy and we can go out and try even more street food.
I know.
I'm excited.
I'm so excited. I love this vibe already. This is something that you can't always find in Tokyo. Mm-hmm. So this is a great alternative if you don't make it to Kyoto or you don't make it to an old traditional town. Come here and get all your traditional Japanese vibes. We're here to enjoy the local delicacy sweet potato at Cher's Kitchen. And we've got different types of sweet potato. I have some crispy, like chip style sweet potato, and you've got...
I got a bruleed sweet potato. So super soft, super beautiful Japanese sweet potato. And I think it's a beni haruka is the variety of sweet potato.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And can you guys hear that little... Can you hear that? You like that? A little bit of food ASMR. It's, yeah, bruleed on the top. Oh!
She loves brulee, but she doesn't even stop talking about it.
I love brulee so much.
Brulee.
I just want to live in it, you know, in a little sweet potato house. It's delicious. It's got kind of this extra layer of flavor because it's stone baked. I don't know, it's almost smoky. There's something to it. Very, very soft, very delicious. And with the ice cream and the crunchy bits of sugar, it's perfect.
Yeah, well, I've got the opposite because mine are really crispy. They're literally like chips. And I love savory food and this isn't sweet. So I could just eat all of these. And funnily enough, apparently they have like a purple chip and no other shop has this, so it's like good luck.
Purple chip? Mm. Purple chip for good luck?
Yum.
Do you want any of this?
Yeah, I'd like to dip mine into yours. Mm. That's what you gotta do, buy both of these, combine it.
With the purple
sweet
chip.
Sweet potato harmony. Tell me you love it. You love it.
I love it.
Yes.
I love it.
And all of these are from Chiba, so they're really fresh. Oh.
Yeah, Chiba sweet potatoes. Because if you didn't know, Narita Airport, even though it's a Tokyo airport, it's in Chiba. We're in Chiba right now, the neighboring prefecture to Tokyo. A lot of people don't know that.
I like this shop because you can sit down and enjoy the street while you're eating. Like, you don't have to stand up, so this is kind of really chill.
It's very chill.
Yeah.
I like the staff too. Everyone's been really nice.
Yeah. My favorite things about this area is kind of discovering these traditional spots. So we're literally in a Japanese garden right now with, you know, we've got bamboo groves behind us and we've ordered a selection of traditional Japanese drinks and snacks.
Yeah, yeah. I'm so excited. This like tea house is so cute. There's a little outdoor eating area and then like a little enclosed area. And I decided to go for the inaka shiruko. Inaka shiruko is like the old style way of making it. They use tsubuan, so it's more textured than using a koshion. And they have mochi in it. I chose mochi.
Nice.
So, yeah, hot red bean soup is basically what it is.
Beautiful.
With hojicha.
Yeah, so I've got a hojicha too, and I also have some like shiratama anko with a traditional matcha. We had matcha this morning, but this is not with a latte. It's just like the pure green tea powder, you know?
Can you have too much matcha?
No. With, what was this your favorite?
Nerikiri or namagashi.
Yeah.
So it's a white bean mixed with mochi with a little bit of red bean on the inside. It's always in a pretty shape and it's delicious.
And it's seasonal. Yeah, yes. I feel like it's the green and yellow, the leaves are changing, but dig in.
Oh, that is thick. I haven't usually had a thick shiruko like this. Ooh, itadakimasu.
You're blowing on that and I'm feeling very zen because if you close your eyes, you can hear the sounds of Japan.
The noise of Japan is...
You have to slurp your matcha, guys.
That's true, that is a Japan sound.
If you're not good with red bean, one thing I can recommend is these shiratama. So these are just literally flavorless mochi balls, but they're so chewy and that looks amazing.
So much mochi.
But they've kind of like...
They've toasted it.
Yeah.
They've toasted the top. Mm. So it's charred.
Mm. Also, my dish had a little bit of gold on the top.
Mm.
Gold leaf from Kanazawa.
You ate it?
I ate it.
Mm.
Getting richer by the second.
You're worth more money now. It's a black market.
Until I release it into the world. And honestly, I've been surprised because this is our first time here.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't realize there was so much here.
I had no idea.
And I'm kind of regretting not bringing like friends and family here because a lot of them fly out from Narita Airport. And
me too.
And this is so great because I know people come to Japan and they don't have a lot of time. They're like, you know, 4 or 5 days just in Tokyo. Mm-hmm. They didn't make it to Kyoto.
Yeah.
This is a great alternative.
Yeah, for sure. So this place doesn't just have traditional food and shops, they also have traditional activities. So we're gonna be doing some archery at Hankyu Dojo.
And I have tried this before, and I was terrible.
Okay, good to know.
But I wanna beat you because I'm a competitive person, so bring it on, Emma.
Okay, all right. Also, this is traditionally done on horseback, so we have our horses. Mine's called Philip.
Mine doesn't have a name.
Oh, anyway, let's shoot some arrows and see who wins.
Bring it on.
Bring it on.
Yes!
Oh,
oh no, that was really good. Oh my god, I don't have the muscle for this.
Okay, good.
Thank oh, she much. Is helping me so much.
Yay! Oh shit! Okay, okay.
Oh my gosh. This is a real workout.
Yes! Good job.
It's such a satisfying noise when someone hits it.
Yes!
Oh my god, Emma's so good.
Yes!
Okay. I surprised myself. That was so close to the middle.
Yes. Oh,
thank you. I'm sweating. It's hot. Oh, I'm exhausted. Oh wow, you keep hitting it. Good job. I feel like my problem is like the aim.
That's a very big problem for something like this.
For the rest of our lives. What? Get back, get on there, get on
you
there.
You got it, you got it, you got it, you got it, you got it.
I do not have it. Ah! That was fun though.
Yeah.
I had a lot of fun.
Woo!
And I definitely lost this competition. So congratulations
Thank
to Emma!
You. Thank you.
Our queen, our archery queen.
Yeah, 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 yeah. So it's just me, guys. I've sent Sarah away because Sarah isn't a huge fan of seafood, but I am. And this area, Narita, is famous for unagi or eel. And so I've come to this place called Kikuya, and they have a egg roll with unagi on the inside. But they also have like eel on rice, which is the more traditional and nice way to eat it. But this place has been around for over 300 years, which is crazy. I think the owner was like the 15th generation, which is nuts. This area is actually crazy about unagi and crazy about eels, because in the Yamato-sando area, there's over 150 shops, and about 60 of them are unagi shops, which is crazy. Okay, I'm just gonna dig in. The eel is from Chiba, and also the sauce is a special sauce that the shop makes, that Kikuya makes. Okay, wow, look at that. Look at those rolls. Itadakimasu. That is like a match made in heaven. Tamagoyaki is like a little bit sweet, nicely cooked, very soft, very fluffy. And then this fluffy, really sauced up piece of eel in the middle is just a really nice, the combination is so good. Just the unagi by itself. Mmm. Super soft and really, really nicely flavored. I feel like in Australia, I didn't really get to eat eel. It wasn't really like a thing in Australia. So coming to Japan and being able to try it, I think it's actually a really special experience. Also, I need you guys to be introduced to the local mascot, Unari, Unari-kun. Guess what he is? 3, 2, 1. He's an eel mixed with an aeroplane. So, very cute. Absolutely love that. That's how crazy they are about eel around here. If you guys are in the area at the right time, there is actually an eel festival, which unfortunately is not on while I'm here. But you know what is here while I'm here? Sarah. So I need to go find her and I'll just finish this really quickly. Okay, let's go.
This is our lovely hotel room for tonight. We're staying at Waku Narita-san Monzen, and it's right on the main street. So it was really convenient.
It's so nice. This is a very modern, but yet still traditional Japanese hotel. Very fancy.
I know, I'm so excited.
There's so much included in the price that we're paying. We get all these drinks. I feel like I get so excited about all the free drinks.
We have.
Ooh, it lights up.
Oh, is this sake? Are we gonna have a little bit of a drink? Tipsy.
I'm so excited, yeah. Beautiful selection of drinks, teas, coffees.
Oh, I saw that we have like this welcome snack and tea, so I'm really excited.
That's awesome.
It's one of my favorite things. Japanese hospitality is always the best thing.
Mwah.
Mwah.
Yeah, it's beautiful. We have a massive TV. Very beautiful, nice big couch, and then our beds look awesome.
I love when they do like kind of a raised tatami and then like a Western bed. It's just like the harmony of Japanese and Western architecture and design.
It's very simple, but it's so clean and fresh, and I just love it. Should we check out the bathroom?
Yes. Also, there's a window where you have a view out in the morning. The temple is literally right next to our hotel, which we'll check out tomorrow morning.
Mm. Oh, the bathroom's so nice. That shower is huge.
Wow.
Oh, nice bathtub.
But we have a public sento bathhouse here.
Exciting.
So we might go for a little dip.
Yeah, I think before dinner, I would love to just refresh, relax, and then, yeah, be fresh enough to eat more food.
Look how spacious it is. Spacious. Spacious.
Guys, it's so spacious.
I feel like this is the perfect way to spend your last night in Japan. Like, you can have a party in here. Yeah. Like, looks so luxurious.
Yeah, if you have like had a great time in Japan, you're like, I wanted to like ball out for my last night and stay in a really nice traditional place close to the airport so it's easy access.
Yeah.
What the hell? Like, this is perfect.
And it has enough space to fit your luggage. People always are like, I can't fit my luggage in my Japanese hotel room. Well, this place is like, you can fit
20,000 luggages.
20,000.
20,000 luggages.
But should we go?
We should go. We should go.
No, refresh them up.
Yes. Let's go. And we'll see you guys at dinner.
Dindins.
Dindins. Yum, 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 yum. Welcome to dinner, everybody.
Welcome.
It has begun. We have in front of us.
How many was it? 50?
I already forgot. 16?
16?
Many dishes in front of us. I don't even know where to begin. There are so many. We have a beef sukiyaki, so we're gonna be cooking some Wagyu beef right in front of us. We have,
unagi?
I have lots of, yeah, unagi, of course.
Seafood.
There's brim, there's duck, there's other fish.
There's caviar. There's
caviar on
beef sushi. Beef. Also, apparently this hotel kind of has some kabuki inspiration. Mm. And so this dinner is the kabuki and Kyoto cuisine. So, you know, this is your final meal in Japan.
Yeah.
Also, we got dessert in front of us already. And it looks so beautiful.
The beautiful big grapes.
Yeah, I think they're kyoho grapes.
Kyoho, like, yeah.
It's probably one of the best meals, fanciest meals I've had in my time here.
This is actually like, yeah, one of the tops.
I'm very excited. Where do we even start?
With a little
itadakimasu.
Ginkgo nuts, my favorite. Did I tell you I tried to cook them and I poisoned myself? This is why I leave it to the professionals. I'm gonna eat. This is like one of the best things about staying in a ryokan, is enjoying the meal. Like, if you stay at a ryokan, you have to book the meal as well.
It's a little extra cost-wise, but you can't beat this experience. And if you haven't had a lot of Japanese foods during your stay, like, look at the variety we have here. Like, from raw sashimi to cooked meat, like wagyu, to Japanese fruit, to tempura even.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen sake served in a teapot, and it's so, like, tiny amount.
Yeah.
Mm, that's delicious.
That's so good, right?
You can tell this is one of the highest qualities of sake, like Junmai Daigin.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
It's so flavorful and so smooth and enjoyable.
It's so light as well. I want some more of that sake.
I know, can we have like a jug of that?
There's also a leaf here. Like, can anyone tell me what the meaning of this leaf is? Is it to fan the queen?
No.
How is it?
It's great. I'm having a great time.
That's great.
Yeah, I'm just trying a little bit of everything. All the flavors are very nicely balanced. And a lot of Japanese cooking and cuisine makes the most of the flavors of the actual item of itself and enhances it just by a little bit of like added flavor.
Mm.
But I'm excited for the sukiyaki. Yeah, so happy that we get to stay here and enjoy this experience together.
So lovely.
Yeah, sleep in big beds, have girls' night. Yeah, then this area has been so surprising for me. It's been awesome.
Oh, guys, I am so glad I asked for the sake. They went all they out. Went. I'm going to get so tipsy.
I'm so worried.
Wow. Mm. That is beautiful. It's Japanese custom to pour the drink for your guest.
Am I the guest?
Apparently.
Cheers.
Cheers.
That's so good.
We have the sounds of the shamisen behind us.
Mm. I'm gonna get drunk if I'm not careful.
You chug that.
That's why I'm in danger.
So this is shabu shabu, so like dip it in and enjoy the flavor. That just melted in my mouth.
Mmm. Wagyu beef sushi.
That looks so
amazing.
With
caviar on top. What the heck?
She's been transported to another universe.
Good morning, guys. We just had a beautiful sleep in our hotel, and now we have a little bit of extra time, so we're going to check out a local temple called Shinshoji. So let's go.
This is the perfect shrine to visit on your last day in Japan, and there are so many stairs, so it's a good workout too.
Yeah.
And I love that the path kind of just leads you here, and I learned a cool fact that Omotesando, which is the name of the path we've been on, it literally means a path leading to a shrine.
Yeah, so I'm like wondering if the Omotesando in Tokyo means the same thing because it leads up to Meiji Jingu.
Oh, you're
so,
right.
Yeah,
I'm that's like, a cool thing.
Is that the same thing?
Maybe yeah. There's more Omotesando out there we've got to discover.
Maybe.
But yeah. Shall we keep climbing?
Let's keep climbing.
I want to see the top. I'm not fit enough. There's some turtles here swimming on the other side. And if you have a penny or a yen, as we say in Japan.
Say a yenny.
You can try and throw it and aim it on the king of the turtles.
It looks like a turtle rock.
It is a turtle rock.
A turtle rock for the turtles.
Yee!
So this temple is relatively quiet right now, which is really nice, but it's actually super busy during New Year's for the New Year's prayers or Hatsumode, and about 3 million people come. And trying to imagine that in this space is crazy because it's huge, it feels super spacious, but yeah, 3 million people.
Not in one day, it's over like a couple of days.
Sorry, over a couple
but
of days.
Yeah, it's definitely popular.
Yeah, no, it's awesome. And also, can you hear that?
Sounds of the airplanes.
Airplanes from Narita Airport.
Yeah.
Woo. Now, just behind the temple, you take a short walk and suddenly you're immersed in nature. There's this beautiful park called Narita-san Park, and there's a waterfall, there's trees everywhere. The vibes are immaculate.
Yeah. And apparently if you come here in the sakura season, there's lots of trees, autumn, the brown leaves, so there's lots to see.
Yeah.
And I think we'll just take a little walk and wind down before, you know, taking our international flight.
Oh yeah, back to wherever we go. But this area has been so amazing. I have been completely blown away by Narita. It's just been beautiful.
Yeah, I highly recommend coming here and spending your final days or your first days here.
Yeah.
But yeah, this was awesome.
Awesome.
Thank you, Narita-san, for inviting us. We'll be back.
We will be back.
Yeah, comment, subscribe, and let us know what your favorite spot was today.
Yeah, and thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, I like that about that. I like that about it.
I like that about that.
Always need a reason to have a snack.
Mm-hmm.
A reason is, I don't need a reason.
You don't need a reason. Here comes the airplane. Oh, thanks, Mom. I'm the mother and the baby. Mm. Let's go. Into traffic.